Say, I'm just fired up to be here today. It's pretty cool, pretty damn cool. I gotta say, I'm just fired up to be here today. It's pretty cool, pretty cool, pretty damn cool.
Yeah! Fired up to be here today. Wow! Woo! Subscribe!
Anybody want some of that candy?
Very nice! Very nice!
What is up, everyone?
Yeah! I gotta say, I'm just fired up to be here today.
Click on subscribe.
Cool stream.
Father on the Bunko.
It's good to be back.
Whee-hee. Oh, yeah! Ooh,
it's so good.
Whoa!
Funko Pop.
Big thing today is we're trying to figure out, is the cool stream goated? Is the cool stream goated or not? So we're trying to figure that out today. So we're going to figure that out. Hopefully by the end of the show, we'll find out if the cool stream is goated. Just something I've been thinking about. And we gotta do this intro. I need about four or five different arms so I could do all these alerts and sounds, GIFs and GIFs and all that stuff.
Pretty cool! Pretty cool! Pretty damn cool! Wow!
Wow! Funko.
Eat an aluminum can. See if we can do the eat aluminum can challenge. Teen challenge. Do the teen challenge. I'm busting out all the references today. Oh, frick. Where's my iced coffee? Hold on a sec. Show without the damn iced coffee. Alright. I need like a gamer chair so I can be comfy and this chair is not. See if we can do a GoFundMe. Get me a gamer chair. Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool! Woo! It's the cool stream, everybody. We're back. Yeah. We're back and better than ever. It's time once again. Let's get into it and let's do it. It's the cool stream. It's one of our favorite shows and it's back, baby. It's cool. Woo! We're going to do another show. Talking about aliens today. Love those little guys. The UAPs. UAPs are out. Unidentified phenomenon, aerial phenomenon, things flying around. And UFOs and stuff that we're talking about today. Woo! It's exciting stuff. It's awesome doing the show. I'm back, baby. Better than ever. Gonna be a lot of fun. It's the cool stream.
Pretty cool.
It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. We're back better than ever with some of the craziest, coolest stuff on the web. Talking about aliens, talking about UFOs, talking about where have we been this whole time. Where have I been? Everyone's been missing out on the show, wondering where it's been going, what's been going on. Hopefully the stream's not going to crash today. That would stink. We're going to have a fun show today. I'm glad to be back. The truth is out there. That's right, the truth seekers. I don't like those guys. We're not going to talk about them, but we've got some fun and cool stuff to do today. The UAP report is out. Unidentified aerial phenomenon. That's what we're calling them now. They're not UFOs anymore. So get that out of your... Get that out of your lexicon. It's UAPs. That's the new...
Click on Lumen, subscribe.
Nomenclature. We're talking about unidentified aerial phenomenons.
Yeah, we got the iced coffee.
Pretty cool.
that's the best new sound alert.
That is crazy. Oh
that,
my word.
That we've had in a long time.
Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
Anybody want some of that candy?
Mitchell Head, does he run the site? That's a good question. That's a good question. Where have we been is another good question. What's been going on? Can't really get into every single little detail. For that, you're going to have to check out the Cool Files.
Cool Files.
It's a website. Damn it, I can't even remember these commands anymore. It's a website that I created in order to talk about some of the conspiracy stuff going on behind the scenes. A lot of stuff that we covered on the Cool Podcast, which is no longer doing new episodes, but you can check that out on YouTube, where you can listen to episodes of the Cool Podcast. It's kind of confusing how all this stuff is intertwined and intertwixed together, which is why some point in the near future we're going to be doing the PowerPoint presentation. I'm trying to explain what the Cool Files is, because frankly, when you do a podcast that's behind the paywall, and you've got listeners who are devoted, and we appreciate those listeners, but not everyone got to hear the whole story. So it's kind of confusing. If you went on the Cool Files now, you never knew about this stuff, you'd be very confused. So we're going to try to explain some of that. You can listen to the Cool Podcast. You can check out the Cool Files website. And the blog is where you want to go to see the latest news. So where have we been? Getting back to that question. Whew, let me just slow down for a second. Where have we been? We've been all across the world.
Yeah!
Pretty cool!
Howie subscribed, and Robert Denby subscribed. I forgot to mention that. 21 months. Coolstream is back. And Howie subscribed for 16 months. The dude, it's so good.
Ooh, it's so good. Food.
And
ooh, it's so good.
I love to see Howie on Twitter commenting, replying to the Mr. Food, to saying the famous catchphrase. Where have we been, though? What's been going on? I've been on the road. I've been on the run from the Shogun Army. Won't get into all the details, but let's suffice it to say we're in a different part. We're not in the Cool Studios. We're somewhere else. But luckily, we've got a Wi-Fi connection. I've got all the stuff set up. I'm ready to do more shows on the road. And so we've got some stuff we're going to talk about in the show, is stuff that I found while I was on the road. On the road again! So that was fun. Recorded some video. Went to a cool place that was all about the UAPs, UFOs, UFCs, and all that stuff. So that'll be coming a little bit later in the show. I'll show you some video that I did of this crazy cool UFO place called the UFO Watchtower. That was pretty fun. Doing a little road trip on the run from the Shogun Army. Kreb is doing okay, I think. What's the Shogun Army up to? Maybe if you read the Cool Files, see some more blog posts that I'll be doing, you'll figure out what's the latest what's news from them. I hope everyone's wanting to know. But enough about that. Let's get into the latest what's news. I had a nice... We'll just put it in quotation marks. I had a nice vacation running from these fanatical freaks of the Shogun Army, but it was also kind of a vacation driving across the country. going out west. That's where I was. That's where I am. Out west. Deep in a bunker somewhere. No one will find me here. So enough about me. Let's talk about the what's news behind the UAPs. UAPP. What is that? What is that? UFO news. A Junkini Village incident. That sounds interesting. No. Well, interesting. Here it is. The UAPTF. In my humble opinion, there's no finer reporter than George Knapp. Cool. Here's the UFO report. UAP report dissected part one. Man, if you go through this thing, it's crazy the stuff that you'll find in here. Not really. There's actually not a whole lot going on. Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert, but we're still going to talk about it because it's the latest What's News. It dropped on Friday. The bombshell blast of the century when it dropped. The best time to get the news, the What's News drop, is late Friday afternoon. That means it's some big stuff. Now they're calling it the UAPTF. 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 I don't know what that stands for. The report is released on the 25th. We'll break it down. See what's going on in this report. Paragraph 1. It's the standard hoo-ha you find from the government. I hate the government, this bureaucracy. And they're trying to keep the UFOs secret, but now they're talking about it. It's kind of like the classic, the blue, Project Blue Book days when they were talking about UFOs and the government. Now they're doing it again. We're going to be hearing about it more and more. A lot of letters in there. Paragraph, standard hoo-ha, simply is why the report was written. It's about UFOs. It was directed in part of the Intelligence Authorization Act for fiscal year 2021. So far, it's probably been my favorite fiscal year. It's been 2021. Okay, what's everyone's favorite fiscal year? What's your favorite quarter? Also, and don't say it's the one with the national parks on the back of it. Is it the first quarter, second quarter, you know, the fiscal year? Okay, so the Senate said that we need to investigate intelligence, signed off by the president. And I think it was signed off by the other president, not the guy that we have now. The other guy, we miss him. We miss him. Old Trump. Aww. He said we need to find out about UFOs. The National Intelligence Secretary of Defense said, you need to submit this document and see if there's a threat posed by UAPs. In the short, the two entities consulted in this document means the subject of UAPs is reaching the highest echelon of U.S. government. So that's how you know it's legit. These guys are talking about it. Q2. That's a good one. First quarter, you can miss your goal and still be like, oh, well, we have three more quarters to make up for it. That's true. That's you know, what they say in football, too. Well, we whiffed on the first quarter. We can still make up for it. Sports ball. Okay. Remember we used to do sports on the show? That was cool. We need to do some of that again. The Olympics. I'm ready for the Olympics. When are they doing that? Okay, I'm all over the place. I'm all over the map today. We need to talk about UAPs. Let's see. UAPs pose a threat, which is later revealed to be the military and civilian aircraft. Though we here at UAP News do not consider them threatening, that is to say that unexpected and dangerous aerial events do not occur, they certainly do. Just ask Sully Sullenberger when he flew into those geese and had to land. It was a dangerous thing that he did, but he landed the plane. Paragraph 2 has some important information. Okay. This is a good breakdown here. UAP news. Paragraph 2, that's probably my favorite paragraph of this whole thing, because it has some important information in it, including the military government are to create relevant processes, policies, technologies, and training for personnel if they encounter UAP. Whoa, that's great. We need more processes, policies about UAPs, what happens when you encounter one. You need to say, we come in peace, greetings, greetings, alien, our alien friends. Let's think about that for a second. Processes. Okay, let's think about this. Processes as are to be developed. All right. I love processes being developed, which is, we understand, it means procedures. What? Procedures and processes? I love those things. Man, that's what, that'll get us, that's going to get us to the finish line. You need to understand. You need to understand these things. We need processes. We need more red tape. That's how we're going to get to the bottom of UAPs. UAPP. Another big step moving forward is it's going to be there to be a policy to report what you have seen rather than ignore it for fear of ridicule or possibly worse. So, you're a mandated reporter about UAPs. Technologies are sorely needed. May have a hefty price tag, but this is something that should have been done 50 years ago. I agree. We should have developed those technologies 50 years ago, and then they would have been out of date shortly after that. So my cynical take on this is, hey, it's the UFO Summoner. That's cool. And this is kind of an interesting website. My cynical take is that that's just a way for them to get more money. We need more money. We need more funding. We need to get more technologies to figure out what the UAPs are, because they pose a threat, even though we never heard of anybody having a run-in with any of these UAPs or any getting blasted by any laser guns or anything like that. So, I don't know if that's going to help. Unclassified. Here it is. Here's the document. Here's the document, and it's huge. It's all 9 pages of just a bunch of stuff about the fiscal year. It's our favorite one so far. The progress of the Department of Defense Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force. Unidentified Aerial Phenomena. They're trying to understand the threat. It's a big threat, so now we need more money. That's kind of how it goes. We need to try to contact, like the movie Contact, sending radio waves. I think that would be better. That would be cool. And that's actually what they're doing over there at Galaxium, is they're trying to make contact. That's kind of what Mr. Rude Guy is doing over at Galaxium these days. He's helping develop some technology to come in contact with the aliens. So anyway, this is like kind of boring. This is the report. They pose a safety threat, so we need more money. Multiple UAPs requiring different explanations, blah, blah, blah. Let's see. Reports. More analysis. Need to screen stuff. Since USG data allow more sophisticated analysis. Here it is. Some of these steps are resource intensive, will require additional investment. More money. That's exactly what we need. I mean, they're spending my taxes on this stuff. UAPs, are you kidding me? Limited data and inconsistency reporting are challenges. Big time. So that the 144 reports, 80 reports involved observation with multiple sensors. Okay, this is the report. Government doesn't want to make it sound interesting either. No. Socio-cultural stigmas and sensor limitations remain obstacles to collecting data on the UAP. Such as how to appropriately filter out radar clutter to ensure safety of flight. Man, I'm trying to make this sound interesting. But some patterns do emerge. The wide variability of reports, blah, blah, blah. There's clustering of UAP observations regarding the shape, size, and particularly propulsion. UAP sightings cluster around U.S. training and testing grounds. Interesting, but we assess that this may result from a collection bias as a result of focused attention, greatest number of latest generation sensors, unit expectations, and guidance to report anomalies. So, all these UFOs are around the U.S. testing training grounds. Handful of UAP appear to demonstrate advanced technology. 18 incidents described in 20 reports. Movement patterns, flight characteristics. Some UAP appear to remain stationary in winds aloft, move against the wind, maneuver abruptly, or move at considerable speed. Whoa. UAP probably lack a single explanation. Could be airborne clutter, birds, balloons, recreational unmanned aerial vehicles, or airborne debris like plastic bags. Oh no, natural phenomenon, ice crystals, moisture, or some are classified programs. And that's where that's not going to be. They're not going to talk about that. Or it could be Russia or China, of course. Or they just don't know. It's exciting stuff. Okay, so let's get to a video. Maybe we'll get some laughs. Maybe we'll have some fun. That's what we're trying to do. That's what we're trying to do today, but I thought I would try to do my own spin. It's all about the spin these days. How are we spinning it? How are we doing
Washington, the U.S. intelligence community on Friday released a hotly anticipated report on what it knows about a series of mysterious sightings of unidentified flying objects by Navy pilots and others. The report, which examined 144 reports of what the government terms unexplained aerial phenomena between 2004 and 2021, is among the first acknowledgments by the U.S. government that it is looking into UFOs as a serious national security concern. UAP clearly pose a safety of flight issue and may pose a challenge to U.S. national security, the report states. Here are the top four takeaways from the report. Investigators
so far hasn't said anything about
sightings represented extraterrestrial life. A senior U.S. official told reporters on Friday, although they didn't rule out the possibility. Of the 100,
to me, it seems like they're like, ah, crap, we got to put this report together at the last minute, and they just slapped it together. We don't know. We don't know, so
44 reports we are dealing with here, we have no clear indications that there is any non-terrestrial explanation for them, but we will go wherever the data takes us, the official said.
COVID. Even did if COVID come from aliens?
From another world, that doesn't come mean the other investigators way around. Know what these strange sightings are. Of the 144 reports covered by the study,
you ask Mitchell Head, he'll tell you where COVID came from.
Investigators were convinced that the majority of the sightings were indeed physical objects, the official told reporters on Friday. Most of the UAP reported probably do represent physical objects, given that a majority of UAP were registered across multiple sensors to include radar, infrared, electro-optical, weapon seekers, and visual observation, the report found.
Truth seekers.
In 11 cases, pilots reported near-miss collisions with these strange objects. For lawmakers, intelligence, and military personnel working on the issue, the bigger and more likely concern was not that alien life is visiting Earth, but rather that a foreign adversary like Russia or China might have developed some kind of next-generation technology that the United States doesn't know about. At least for now, there's no evidence that the strange sightings are foreign surveillance or new technology, the report found. Still, it's possible that some of the 143 unexplained cases might wind up being foreign technology. That's one of the reasons the report doesn't include more examples of sightings that haven't previously been made public. They're very sensitive to, if this is an adversary, you want to be really careful about saying, we know this and we don't know that, said Representative Jim Himes.
Is this guy falling off a ladder? The aliens made this guy fall off a ladder.
We know this and we don't know that, said Representative Jim Hines, a Connecticut Democrat on the House Intelligence Committee, who received a briefing on the matter from Navy and FBI officials last week.
That's a cool boat.
The report is going to be a little unsatisfying for that reason and that reason alone.
What are these videos for?
The limited amount of high-quality reporting on unidentified aerial phenomena hampers our ability to draw firm conclusions about the nature or intent of UAP, the report found. Officials don't believe
the men in black. They're probably behind this too. Here come the men in black.
180 days. If you're anything like me, you've been waiting for this day for at least 180 days.
Yeah.
Now it's here. And was it all worth the wait?
Pretty cool.
What's up, everyone? This is John Greenwald Jr., founder and creator of theblackvault.com. And that's right. The UFO or UAP or whatever you want to call them reports.
I'll
go over just some of the key points about
everyone.
Because that report, all whopping 9 pages of it, is the subject of this quick blast.
Nine pages of this damn thing.
That's right. The UFO UAP report is here.
Yes.
Now, I was debating on whether or not I was going to do this video, and I thought, you know what? Let's just go ahead and throw update you guys. I'm not
going to
go over every single aspect of the report, but I am going to point out a few things. I know some of you,
I'm surprised, from New
because I thought everybody used social media, but doesn't use social media like Twitter, Facebook, stuff like that, that you primarily just watch YouTube and those types of videos. So I thought, let's get this video out there and update you guys that the report is here. Fantastic. So let's get into it because I believe you might be a little let down if you had high hopes.
What?
Now, if you did see my video about this, if you saw what essentially was kind of a more little speculation and stuff like that on
exactly
my part,
what I just did,
but also pull juxtaposing that with history, the question mark
the
was what were
UFOs.
We going to get? And I truly thought that we weren't going to get much, and we didn't. But what really surprised me was the fact that we didn't get really anything at all. Yes, there are 9 pages, but I thought it would be a little bit lengthier. And what I wanted to see, and bear with me here because you might get mad at me for saying this, is I wanted to see debunking on a small level. Because it would show us that they actually are researching, investigating, and can solve some of this leaked material that has come out that they admitted was real, admitted that they were that it was taken by U.S. Navy pilots, but they would not put a designation on it. They said it was even being utilized by the task force that created this report that you're about to...
That's a good point. All right. I like this guy now, the Black Vault. He makes a good point. Pentagon came out... released videos and of all of this stuff. Didn't say anything, but it also didn't not say nothing. It left it open to interpretation. Yeah, they should have said here's what was in the video. I guess they don't know. But there's some people here that will watch that think they do know. They do know. They should have addressed the controversy. Some of these videos. Do I even have the video? Well, we'll show it. It's the famous Pentagon video of the UAP, the UFO flying around, that originally was released by our friends and the guy from Blink-182 to the stars. To the stars! Should have that pulled up, because this is their big day. Let's give a shout out to the stars. They helped bring this about. They released the Pentagon video, and then the Pentagon had to say, yes, this is a video that we did. Then they released the video. So they've just keep releasing the same videos over and over again. And thanks to the stars, they were able to the vault. Here it is. Virtual Analytics UAP Learning Tool. Scout and Vault. They were able to get the word out. And there's the Adam Project. Adam! They were able to get the word out They leaked the videos. Then the Pentagon had to say, yes, the video. These are the videos. Then they released the videos. Then 60 Minute did another thing about it. And they talked to the same guys again from To the Stars. I didn't even watch it. I probably should have watched it. This is just some of the latest stuff on the UAPs. And then that led to doing the government doing stuff. And then they come up with their report. So it's kind of just the same, saying the same stuff over and over, which is what tends to happen with some of this stuff. There's nothing really new happening. It's just the same stuff over and over. But that's where we come in, try to make it funny.
Go over with me. Yet, they wouldn't say if it was unidentified or not. And I'll be the first to say, I thought that was part of the plan. I thought that meant that they were going to take that material and say, you know what, Senator Rubio and your committee, we can identify this. The media grabbed a hold of it, made a big thing out of it, but there are some other ones that we can't identify. But essentially, it would have shown us they are doing their job. In reality, we heard about no specific cases whatsoever.
The government's not doing their job?
It was this broad overview, and
they're just asking for more money?
Preliminary assessment, unidentified aerial phenomena.
I can't believe the government's not doing jack squat. I think they just had some intern write up this thing. Due date's tomorrow. Let's get the intern to write up this thing. We don't have to actually do anything. And maybe some of it's classified. Uh-oh. What are all these spammers? Why are all these spammers in the chat all this every damn episode? Can we get the mods in here? What the hell? Okay, let's get to some other stuff. This is kind of interesting. We'll have to go back to the Black Vault. He was one of the ones... I was looking for stuff the day that the thing dropped. So this is a new video. This one's kind of weird. This was live streamed on the 25th. The UAP Intelligence Task Force messages report. Big follows.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in the world.
Grant Cameron, White House UFO.
This is a panel. It's June the 25th, 2021, and the report from the Pentagon on UFOs is now
UAPs.
Out. And I've lost my screen.
Sorry. Do you want it right now? That's all everyone can see live is your screen, if that's what you want.
Okay. No. I've got some slides to show here. Okay. So everybody can still see it. Okay. So this is a panel that we've set up for. The government has given their side of
the
disclosure
government
today, and there's two entities.
The government
that are
is at
disclosure.
It again.
One is, whoever on the government side or
the government.
Inside the government.
Look at, check out the Zoom. Check out the Zoom chat that they had. Holy crap. Look at all these people in here.
The second,
this is alt. Look at this.
One we have,
look at all these people.
host is Sinead Wellahan, who is my assistant out of Toronto, and she has great self-will. She
so
is
many Zooms.
Rams, but she's a... cheerleading leader, so I'm going to turn it over to Nicole.
Doing too many skin flicks.
And to Sinead to open it up.
I've been
keeping
my drivers updated. I've been doing all the stuff. So, I don't know. We're just going to get a crash every episode now. It's fine. Fine.
I prefer the European goal because it's
fine, everybody.
In Europe, and we want to start there. But basically, it's to get you to
see what's going on in the Zoom. There's so many people in the Zoom.
Development as the human race. So for me, my experiences started when I was a very young child. I had a whole bunch of downloads between the age of 9 and 11. One of
oh,
which
crap.
Was
she got downloaded.
Each one of us
to
is
the
a
web.
Universe. Each person is a whole universe, and that each one of us is also part of the universe, the one we all. So I had a whole series of experiences through my life, did not know how to understand them or what to make of them at the time, never told anybody about them. And then in 2017, I had my first ET experience, and I was not involved in the
phone home
world at all. So that was my invitation, they told me. And then 2 years later, I got what I call the cosmic frying pan over the head. It was like, dong, okay, it's time to wake up now.
Cosmic frying
and,
pan.
You know, we mean business, and we've been very supportive for a very long time, and okay, bam, you know, wake up. Boom. It's time. Let's go. Take ownership. Take responsibility.
Gerard Pratt.
Own
Which
who you
that?
Really are. Own your real, your true nature. Come together with others who are also doing that. Have
Jeff
these conversations
Dimmers.
And, you know, really push the
Drew
vibration
Gregory
up and Sova.
Nurture
what we all want, which
Carl.
Is the development of our nature, so that we can come to a new level of
Kevin
consciousness.
Kevin Estrella.
That's what I really received. So I'm going to stop there and lob it over to the lovely Desta, who has been also patiently waiting to tell her story.
Talk about UAPs.
We just wanted to give you some examples of how you can tell your story. And we really encourage you all to.
This is the Intelligence Task Force messages
so,
report.
Thank you all so much for being here, Desta. Please take it.
Aliens are demons. That's what someone's saying in the chat. The other chat.
Hello, everyone. I what guess is I'll up, say everyone? That I totally agree with Sinead, obviously, and Nicole in that the message.
Now we're getting the full screen of all the Zoomers. Heard. That's good. That's what we want to see. Why is this thing always crashing?
Off on the right kind of note here. I see some hands raised. So,
maybe I need a new laptop.
Later time, I'll remind everybody if you do want to speak and participate, please raise your hand. It's on the bottom of your screen under reactions. That's how we'll
1983
know that
at
you
the movie theater.
Just listen.
What with what everyone has just been saying.
Whoa, look at this guy's eyebrows.
Because I came into this through you know, studies in consciousness.
Dang, those things are insane.
That led to
like a
what
damn anime character.
Became initiations of contact, because my experiences were deliberate,
contact.
You know, in that they were the result of my attempts to initiate.
Pretty cool! Pretty damn cool!
Anderson subscribed again. Tier 1 subscribed for 26 months.
CE5. Something that myself and others, including James from Engaging the Phenomenon, are more inclined
Phenomenon.
To categorize now as cognitive human interface, a term that we selected because of its inclusion in the official presentation slides from the ATIP program.
And okay. I thought there'd be something more interesting to this, but it doesn't look like it. Doesn't look like anything much going on there, so we're just going to continue.
Alrighty, big UFO news to come out today. The long-awaited UAP report finally dropped from the U.S. government today. Let's break it down real
the
quick.
The government.
The report says 144 UAP sightings were reviewed and that it can
UAPs.
Only come to the conclusion on one of them. This report is largely inconclusive about what UAPs are in our airspace. Before I continue on, let me put on the table and be clear with you what my position
let me be
is
clear.
On these UAPs. I
don't UFOs.
Know. I'm agnostic. I haven't seen any conclusive evidence that these are alien in nature, but it is delightful to talk about it and the potential.
We love
that these
it.
Maybe could be aliens. Maybe we don't know.
Love the UFOs.
The universe is a huge place. It's 13 billion years old, with billions and billions of galaxies.
Billions and billions.
Billions and billions of stars with their billions and billions of
All right, Carl Sagan.
How can we not be alone in this universe? So to continue on, this report also talked about how some of these sightings
doing it in this parking lot.
These physical objects in the sky.
This is breaking news. So you had to record right then and there.
Equipment in different locations at the same
what?
Time. That is remarkable. And some of these sightings also demonstrated
is that
advanced
true?
Technologies that the U.S. government does not have. The U.S. government is essentially saying we don't know the source of these sightings. That is remarkable for the U.S. government to admit it does not know what is
Whoa.
Flying around in our airspace. That is really, really
That's
something.
Insane.
Today I reached out to U.S. Senator
that
Michael
is crazy.
He sits on the Senate intelligence community. He is here in Colorado. He is from Colorado. I asked him for a statement. His press secretary said that he is very concerned
He loves the UFOs.
These sightings, especially sightings over the western states, which is interesting because this report did not give any specifics about any of the 144 sightings on where they were.
It is interesting because we're going to be talking about some sightings over the western states. I want to check this one out. This is sanctioned buffoonery is what this channel is called. Sanctioned buffoonery. It's kind of
funny. Hello, everybody.
Funny.
Welcome to the channel. Welcome to the show. And we have here the official report from the Office of the Director of Intelligence about UAPs.
Sanctioned buffoonery.
UFOs. And I suppose they got a rebranding, so people were afraid to say UFO, so now they're saying UAP, as if that's a lot better.
UAP.
Initial reactions. I've gone through this. It's 9 pages long, which is relatively short.
Sanctioned. I want to hear some more buffoonery.
There are
sanctioned buffoonery.
That there's a wide range of reactions, and one camp is very much, you know, this is nothing. This is disappointing.
This is crap. And the other guys say this is cool.
Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
And then there's another camp that says this is it. This is the smoking gun. Disappointed. I'm actually quite surprised they came out and
snacks
open
the Dollar Tree
were out as they are, and I'm surprised the government is saying the things and the way they're saying these things. I'm
sanctioned
actually
surprised
they're saying it.
Please like, share, and subscribe.
Even with, like, Project Blue Book,
as what I said,
forthrightness.
Project
it. It
Blue Book
dismissive of these accounts. Now this there's no conclusions. There's no
Russian. It's the Russians.
Some people were expecting
it's
the
huge.
Doors to open, and for some military general to say, "And here's Boo Boo from the planet Galbulon, and he's here to say a few words." And some alien would walk out these doors and
that
say,
would be
okay,
funny.
Well, "Hello, everybody. Hello, humanity." Some people would want that, and some people wanted would be satisfied even if that had happened.
That would be
small
funny.
Steps. I do think
Boo Boo
this is a step
from
in the right
Zebulon.
Direction. Let's go through it real quick. I keep saying that. Let's go through this. So if you go down here to the executive summary, this summarizes it quite executively. And this is straight from the report. So number one, the limited amount of high quality reporting on unidentified aerial phenomena, UAP.
UAP. It stinks. People are mad that it's not.
Okay, just got finished reading this report from the Office of the Director of National Intelligence, and yeah, they don't know shit.
What?
But they know how to go to Mars and put remote vehicles and
they need
drones.
Elon Musk.
And we got
doing
people
UAPs.
In a space station orbiting planet Earth. But we don't know what the hell's in our own skies. Huh. I'm confused.
Okay.
So the big report is finally here.
Now this is the guy we need to hear from. Mick West. He's a big time debunker. He also kinda did a breakdown of some of the Pentagon videos. And let's see what he has to say. These are kind of These are not the most exciting videos, reading a
preliminary
piece of
assessment
paper.
Of the unidentified aerial phenomenon Office of the Director of National Intelligence Unclassified
what
Report.
Frick?
25th of June, 2021. I've looked at the report, gone through it
He's
a couple of times,
debunks.
But what I want to do now is go through it again and
he has the website
Metabunk. Now, long story short, I'm fairly happy with the report.
Freaking
I think it kind of more or less says what I've been saying for a long time. That
people
a
are saying
things.
It.
We don't have enough information. There's always going to be things that are unidentified. There are things like birds and balloons that are going to show up on sensors. And we should try to figure out what these things are. And, no evidence of aliens, no great evidence of amazing technology. But not everyone agrees with that assessment, so what I want to do is go through the report and try to explain what I see in the report and what justifies that assessment. Okay. So, page 2, scope and assumptions. This basically tells us like, who does the report and where they got all the information from. The only important thing on this page, really, is this assumption at the end. It says, various forms of sensors that register UAP generally operate correctly and capture enough real data to allow initial assessment. But some UAP may be attributable to sensor anomalies. Basically, that means that most of the time the radar works and the AT-FLIR system works, but sometimes it does not.
Sometimes it screws up.
When it does not, that may create a report of a UAP. Next page. Page 3, the executive summary. Now, this is kind of the important page. It has all the most important information and conclusions, and some of the later stuff, even though it should be more detailed, actually omits some of the stuff that was listed here. So you really need to refer to this page whenever you look at something that comes later in the report. All right, the executive summary. The limited amount of high-quality reporting on unidentified aerial phenomena hampers our ability to draw firm conclusions about the nature or intent of UAP. So they're basically saying they don't have enough information to know what the nature of the problem is, or if the UAP means something. I'm not sure what that really means, like aliens meaning something. Okay, the UAP task force considered a range of information on UAP described in US military and intelligence community reporting, but because the reporting lacks sufficient specificity, ultimately recognized that a unique tailored reporting process was required to provide sufficient data for analysis of UAP events.
They want more money. Okay, I'm tired of this report. It's so boring. They don't know anything. But I am interested in what our this guy here, Metabunk, UAP, UAP. I'm interested in what he's got to say about UAPs. And I should have a video pulled up for that. This is kind of cool though. UFO sightings. We'll get to that in a minute. James Deem, types of UFOs. Trufos. Let's see. And I'm just clicking through, seeing what we got here. I thought I had his website pulled up. Let's see if I can find it. Because he had some interesting info about UAPs. Here it is, Metabunk. Metabunk.org. That's his website, McWest. He's talking about some of his videos. This is the big videos that has everyone going crazy, believing in these things because of these videos. The FLIR video. Taken after a famous encounter with hypersonic zigzagging tic-tac by pilots from the Nimitz. And there's a gimbal video too. So he's discussing the videos. Go Fast footage from Tom DeLonge, Academy of the Stars, Bird Balloon. Okay, video U.S. jet encounters an unknown object. Tom DeLonge. Aliens? So he's got some cool videos talking about... He's debunking. So let's check out some debunking of some of this stuff so we can figure out... We can get a second opinion. In an second opinion. James Deem. James Deem. Unidentified aerial phenomena. Which have taken the phenomenon. Speculation the interwebs. About the nature of whoa, the there's one of them.
Whether they could be alien UFOs, and why the Pentagon what have released them freak? Now. Here at Cool Worlds, we do not study UFOs or atmospheric anomalies.
Oh, this is but Cool I World. I hope we're not going to get curious about these videos. Hope we're not going to get muted, banned for playing this video. Probably Metabunk. Metabunk is going to talk about it.
Okay, so hi Mick, thanks so much for joining me on Cool Worlds today. As soon as these videos from the Pentagon dropped, the internet has been exploding, wondering whether this could be a confirmation of aliens. I think aliens exist is now one of the top trending things on Twitter right now. Everyone's super excited and interested in what's going on.
What the frick is these videos about?
Voices from the other side offering some more sober thoughts about what we're seeing. And you have sort of I've seen your work.
We need to break down of the videos. And hopefully we don't get taken down for this.
That's the oldest video.
That would stink.
It's actually a very small video. It's like 200 pixels wide or something like that. Very, very small.
It's very, very blurry.
And it shows
very
like
nice.
A dark dot in the distance, dark kind of shape. And the camera operator,
very nice.
Yeah, following this thing, is cycling through different cameras trying to get a better look at it. But you never really get any good look at it. The object itself, if you pay attention to what's going on, the object itself never actually moves on the center of the screen. It does appear to move, but that's only because the camera is changing. It changes lenses between like a narrow field of view and a wider field of view, or it's changing between the infrared mode and the TV mode, the visible light mode. So whenever it has to change from one camera to another, the camera loses the lock on the object and has to reacquire it. So what we're seeing basically is an essentially static object. It is actually moving. It's because you can see that the camera is tracking from right to left, because you can see the numbers, the heading at the top of the screen changes. So it is moving. So it's entirely consistent. With
it's
it being
probably
a plane that's very far
it's a plane
away, probably somewhere in the range of 50 to 100 miles away, and the jet that's following it again perhaps doesn't realize just how far away it is and thinks that it's a little bit closer and
it's
moving a bit differently.
It's a tic-tac.
It's a bit smaller than it actually is. It could be a quite large plane 100 miles away.
Right. Mm. So if I can ask, why didn't they catch that on the radar then?
So there's an explanation. It's just a plane.
It wasn't where they thought it was. It's the same thing with the Chilean case. Radar's great if you know where to look, but if you're looking in like sector A and it's in sector Q, then you're not going to see it in sector A. So if they were just looking in a range of say like 40 miles in front of them, they're not going to see it on the radar. He got a ping on his radar, I think.
Ping.
And you see the little range crop up, but it shows 99.99, which means it wasn't able to get an actual range distance, which could mean that it was blocking it somehow, but it could also just mean that it was just too far away to get an accurate reading. I think that's probably what happened.
Okay.
He thought there was something close to him. He asked the ship, perhaps, if there was something next to them, and they looked directly in front of him and didn't see it, but it was really over here, so that's why they didn't see it.
And that one definitely looks the least strange.
Sector 7G.
I would say, looking at it from the outside. So moving on to Gimbal, which we seem to see something which looks like it's rotating. There's two blobs. You've talked about this in a few of your videos over on your channel, which I will make sure to link down below. But tell us, what do you think
is
going on?
Click on subscribe.
What I think
okay, now this is the big video. These guys aren't very exciting, but this is kind of interesting. I probably just watch this on my own time. All these videos I should probably just watch on my own time, but I'm watching them today. I want to get re-situated with some explanations from the skeptical point of view of some of the famous Pentagon videos. That's what has people in a tizzy about UAPs, are some of these videos. So that's what we're doing here today. We're just chilling out, and we had our first OBS crash of the day, and so I'm gonna have to deal with that later. But Frank, thankfully, we're past that. Probably because there was someone spamming the chat. Anyway, let's watch to see if we can get an explanation. This one's probably a balloon, or probably a balloon boy.
Is that it's actually the glare from the infrared, So the engines of a plane are very
here we
hot,
go.
And they show up in the heat-sensitive camera essentially as bright lights. Now, in this video,
Meta-bonk.
It's inverted, so hot is black. So it looks like
it's hot
a black
hell.
Object. And you've got the shape of the glare. Now, you're familiar with in astronomy, you often see what looks like a cross. Over a
you see the cross in the sky
because of
because God Jesus
effect.
Did
and
it all
this
the stars.
Actually, the aperture of the camera has an effect on what the glare looks like. And what's happening, I think, here is that you're getting essentially a flying saucer shaped glare, which I've actually replicated with.
Okay, so this is what he did on some of his videos.
Because it's so bright, because the engine is so hot, it's obscuring.
He's
the actual outline of the plane, which you might see. Very hot anyway, so you wouldn't see very much of it. So you just, all you're seeing is this glare of the engine. Now, where it gets confusing is where it seems to rotate.
Yeah.
And this is quite a difficult thing to explain to people, but essentially, it's kind of a limitation of the camera system that they have. They mount it in such a way that it can only rotate along its forward axis, and it can only do a kind of an up and down rotation around one horizontal axis. And to be able to track something, you actually need three axes of rotation.
So we need better technology.
Left to right, when it's actually tilted down a bit, it actually ends up having to rotate the camera, and that rotation is internally corrected for. But because they're doing an internal correction of the rotation, this means that the scene doesn't rotate, but anything that's an optical artifact within the camera does rotate. So yeah, the shape of the glare itself rotates. And this is something I've replicated this exact thing with camera setups of my own, using like a small camera mounted on an arm and rotating it, and then applying derotation. And you see this exact same thing, a kind of a saucer-shaped glare that rotates independently of the horizon, which happens to be my garage in the video I made. But yeah, this is something you can demonstrate that it happens. It makes perfect sense if you look at the actual mechanics of the gimbal system. The gimbal, if you look at the patterns they describe, gimbal, that it will, they have a gimbal lock correction that happens between plus or minus three.
This is very advanced. He kind of just breaks down how the gimbal works, which is, I think they use that doing movies. It's the arm that helps the camera stay stabilized. So these videos are using complicated little cameras on jet planes, and I guess the people doing the videos don't know what the hell they're doing, so that's why they end up with these crazy anomalies. So it doesn't explain that part. So we've debunked the bunker. I guess I'll just go back and watch this on my own time. It's kind of boring. Oh. Wow, the subscriptions are rolling in, everybody. Poff Deluxe.
Pretty cool! Pretty damn cool! Woo!
Wow!
Woo!
Take me to your dealer. Poff Deluxe, subscribe tier 1. Subscribe for 27 months. Holy moly, that's so long. That's 2 years.
Hey, I'm watching the ghoul stream here.
Yeah. Got that. This is the new Pog Champ. The Michigan paranormal guy. We're watching Mick West debunk the camera of the gimbal video footage of UFOs, but I don't think I'm done with that. I think I'm over it. I think I want to get into some of the videos that I did. Speaking of making videos, I did some videos. I went on a road trip. Running from the Shogun Army, I went out west, and they've seen UFOs out there. And we went to this place called the UFO Watchtower. And here's their website. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
Pretty cool. Going in the UFO Watchtower over in Colorado. Colorado. The aliens have landed. The mystical heart of the mystical San Luis Valley. It's like Guache County. We went there. We paid to get in. You can camp out there. It was so windy. It was insanely windy. It was crazy. You ever wondered what a real UFO looks like? Have you ever wondered if there's life on other planets? Judy Messolini of Hooper, Colorado, wondered the same thing. She watched as the X-Files. After watching the show after show, she was glued to the TV. She realized she was hearing things like the Great Sand Dunes and the San Luis Valley on many of these episodes. So, she created the UFO Watchtower. So, it's up there in Colorado, near the big sand dunes, the crazy lady down the road. She wrote a book about it. And there's a garden there, which we're going to do some videos showing the garden of the Watchtower. Looks like they have a live webcam, too. Oh. I thought this was a live webcam. So they have the garden. We're going to watch. They've built this thing in the garden. So here's a little story, I guess, about the garden. It's in front of the Watchtower. And they said that there was a vortex. Okay, so 15 psychics visited the tower and said that there were different vortexes in the garden, the Eye of Pisces. So they made a rock garden, you can meditate, and now there's a bunch of stuff. It doesn't look like this. Well, I'll just show you what it looks like. Let's watch the video. Okay. UFO Watchtower. Here it is. Here's the video of when we went to the UFO Watchtower. Look at that. Crazy cool out there.
Look at that. Wow. Look at
the big mountains. There's the dunes off in the distance. The 21st birthday UFO Watchtower. Yay! Happy birthday. The Watchtower can drink beer now. Since opening the UFO Watchtower, 25 psychics have visited. And they said that they're vortexes. Vortexes is an opening to a parallel universe. So you're supposed to walk through the garden, feel the vortex. Don't take anything from the garden or else it's bad karma. I didn't take anything from the garden. So this shouldn't be the bad karma that's causing the stream to crash. But look at all this stuff out there. I think that's one of my big regrets is that I didn't leave anything in the garden. Maybe that would have given us some good karma.
Pretty cool.
There's a lot of, this is the garden. There's a bunch of stuff. A bunch of knickknacks that people have left out there to bring good luck. And there's big mountains out there. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
Pretty cool.
There's the dunes. There's all kinds of. There's Space Force sticker. There's Bigfoot. There's a Bigfoot statue. So you can just go out there and put your stickers or put any kind of thing. You've got to pay admission. And there they had some face holes, some alien face holes there, which are kind of cool. The UFO Watchtower. Bigfoot is he's a cryptid. Some people think Bigfoot's an alien. And there's a little UFO thing. There's a lot of weird stuff out there. There's aliens. There's an alien with a mask on. A bunch of stickers. One of my big regrets is that I didn't bring any Coolstream stickers to stick all over this stuff. Free advertising. That's what that would have been. But they've got all kinds of cool stuff out here. You can check out here in the garden where there's vortexes and stuff. And the wind was just whipping like crazy out here. There's some minions. Are the minions aliens? That's a question we should be asking. And there's Java the Hutt. He's an alien. And people just bring all kinds of junk out there. It's kind of cool.
Pretty cool!
Pretty cool. And there's little sculptures. There's just all kinds of little things. There's the Happy Feet DVD. Happy Feet. This is kind of funny. It's Superman. There's a Superman statue, and there's this guy's picture on it. Gabe approved. Don't know who Gabe is, but he approves. He approves of the Superman and the UFOs, UAPs. So it's kind of a crazy cool place. I wish I had left a sticker. Would have slapped a sticker on top of one of these aliens. So you'd come out there and you'd see the cool stream. Or if maybe I'd taken a marker and written the cool stream on all this stuff. So people would see it. And then they would come watch the show. And then they would saw all the technical difficulties that we have. So anyway, these are some of the sculptures out here in the Vortex Garden. I took the video. In case people are tuning in. I took this video walking around part of the big road trip, going through Colorado, checking out the UFO watchtower, and they've just got all the stuff everywhere. And there's a big, this one's cool. This
hey, I'm watching the ghoul stream here.
This one's cool. This has got some of these UFO statues. Check that out. That's cool.
Pretty cool. Pretty damn cool.
Wow. So here's the aliens. Look at these guys. They got, and people just take all their junk. Put a, there's a pair of sneakers. And this alien's got a face shield on, but there it is. Yeah, it has a big UFO with stickers on it. Just imagine there's some cool stream stickers on that. And this guy's cool. Look at him. He's got sunglasses. It's pretty cool. Pretty damn cool. And yeah, that's what it was like out there. The wind was whipping. That's why there's no sound, because all you'd hear is just... There's another alien. Look at this guy. Yeah, we come in peace, is what he's saying. Aliens all over the place. And since we were out in Colorado, I think one of them, I think one of the Bigfoots or something had a little weed joint. And you're not supposed to take stuff. Anyway, this one was funny. I liked this little crazy character. It's crazy. He's got weird sunglasses and a crazy skull teeth on it. Freaky. Freaky weird. When you go out to the watchtower, it's a fun little stop on the road again. And just imagine we got another cool stream sticker on there. I mean, there's tons of stickers. You're in a cult, call your dad. And there's an anonymous. No. Even Anonymous was out here doing stickers, and there's a little Japanese chin dog sticker. InfoWars. No. Uncover the truth. So many of these stickers. Man, there's an alien under there. He's not looking so good. He's not looking so good under there. They're just some neat little UFO sculptures. So, we were out there in the garden, in the vortex, looking at all the weird sculptures and weird stuff, the aliens and stuff. There's the Bigfoot. And there's another Bigfoot. This one was near the entrance, so it's a big, it's like a little dome-shaped building, and then it's got a thing you go up to the top and look out for UFOs, but we didn't go up there, it's too windy. We did go inside the gift shop. We exited through the gift shop, so they had all these little alien guys everywhere. So much alien stuff. Some of the people in there were talking to the lady behind the table. And so this is the book of some of the UFO sightings that they've had. She was talking about how a little girl... That's supposed to be a picture of UFO. I don't know if you can see it. She was just talking about how many UFOs people have seen, and these people were talking to her about that they see UFOs too. And so that was kind of cool to happen across that. So there's tons of this UFO alien swag everywhere. And a lady who was behind the desk was very friendly, talking about UFOs. I crashed in Roswell, the UFO festival. And then they had some cool shirts. Shirts! Got a couple of shirts. UFO Watchtower. Check that out. From Hooper, Colorado. Not from this weld. World famous UFO Watchtower. I should have sent everyone postcards. Posted cards from there. But they had all kinds of cool stuff. Mugs. Anything you could ever want with the alien on it. Coffee mugs for your bean juice. And they had all... They had... These were cool. I liked these little posters that had all kinds of pictures. And tried to take some pictures of them. Some close encounters. Photos of UFOs. UAPs, UFOs, all you could ever want. What is a UFO? See, close encounter entities, so there's some entities that people have seen. UFO watchtower. Aerospace plane propulsion. And there's an alien guy in there. It's a cool statue. Things are looking up at the UFO watchtower. UFO seekers line up all along the watchtower. Like the Bob Dylan song. So that was cool. The great sand dunes are out there. And there were some mutilations. Supposedly. There were some mutilations.
Pretty cool!
And... So, people have been seeing UFOs on the watchtower. There's just some footage from inside the souvenir shop. There was an interesting conversation going on about people racism or something. Well, people were not as racist in Colorado, but we won't get into that. There's some socks. Yay! And some stickers! And I got a sticker, put it on my water bottle. A lot of cool stickers. All the lady that owns it, she does the screen printing, and I guess they do the stickers too. Stickers and postcards. Yay. So check out if you're out there. And I got the hat. I got that hat. I should probably be wearing it right now. Maybe that would bring me some good karma. Nothing but bad karma for the first show we've done in the last month. And there's the name. There's my name that I wrote in the guest book. And I put Twitch, put the name, put Coolstream on there. So here's a picture of an alien. Broad, flat nose, thin lips, slim face with feminine chin. Olive complexion. Is that how you would describe an alien? Olive complexion makes you think of someone from the Mediterranean. But an alien, I think they must literally mean like a green olive. Because they're green skinned. But usually when they say olive complexion, it's sort of just someone with a tan from Italy or Greece. So that's the UFO watchtower. Italians or aliens? Oh, no. We can't say that. There's a little alien statue. Spent a lot of money at the gift store, so that was the... that's the UFO watchtower, everybody. Pretty cool.
Pretty cool! Pretty damn cool!
So that's the UFO watchtower. Pretty damn cool. They have a cool website, one of the coolest websites we've ever seen out here. So you can go out there and camp. Well, it was very windy. Very, very windy when we went. Let's see. Other cattle mutilation. We're not going to look at that. You can call Judy up. She owns the watchtower. You can go... The UFO Roundup. They were on Vice, too. Of course, everything that we talk about usually ends up on Vice. Here's a picture of my dog, Everest, with the Frisbee. He's a big fan. Way. UFO Watchtower. It was pretty cool. Pretty damn cool. Go check it out. If you're over in there in Hooper, Colorado. There's Bill Clinton with a UFO. Second Life. If you're on Second Life, it's for adults only. You can't stream it on Twitch. But I guess they have UFO Watchtower on Second Life. which is pretty damn cool if you ask me. I'm gonna check this out. It looks really cool, actually. I have to go check that out. And what the heck is that? What the bleep do we know about UFOs? What the heck is that? It's given the picture by someone, taken in 1987. Please note, he saw something and then took a picture of it. In other words, it was there before he got the camera out. Whoa, it's a UFO. It's a UAP. It's a UAP. PP. There it is. The UFO Watchtower. Hope everyone enjoyed the video. Hope everyone enjoys the last episode of the show. because OBS is never going to work for me ever again. But that's fine. Go to the YouTube. You'll see the edited version. If you're on YouTube watching it now, thanks for watching. And this seems like music that should be the end of the show. That's why I'm doing this transition. But it's not. Or maybe it should be. Maybe we just quit while we're ahead. Not quit, but you know. Oh, the UFO Watchtower. It started as a joke. When we saw the UAPs. It's a hotspot of mysterious sightings. San Luis Valley, the Bermuda Triangle of the West. Out of this world. It's crazy. Little green men. As what you'll see out there, the UFO Watchtower. It was a cool, fun, cool place to go visit on my trek out west. Out west, running from the Shogun army who've been chasing me because of stuff that happens with Podnet Media. If you don't know what that is, well, you just need to get informed. okay. The Crazy Lady Down the Road is the book that she wrote. Miss Olini. What psychics have told her that there was a vortex on the property. I didn't get to meet the owner, Judy Mussolini. But she had a lot of cool stuff out there. UFO Watchtower. If you're ever out there, probably not a place that people would go out of their way to check out. If you happen to be in the area, I guess I should say. Where is it? Here it is. UFO Watchtower. The Sand Dunes. The Watchtower, the Sand Dunes. There's another area. This place is kind of weird. Crestone. Wanted to go check that out. Has a lot of weird, kind of a weird place with lots of interesting stuff. It's an interesting part of the world that you can go visit if you want. If you don't, that's fine too. The truth is out there. What else? Should we watch some more videos or something? I don't know. I don't know what to do anymore. Good thing I can just sit here and just figure it out whatever I feel like doing is what we're gonna do. That's the show. We've got MUFON.
Hey, I'm watching the Ghoul stream here.
Let's see what's going on with MUFON. MUFON.org, the Mutual UFO Network. We should call it the MUPON.
Access granted.
Mutual UAP Network. MUPA. MUAPA. They should call it the MUAPA. Whoa.
Case 112171.
A New York witness at Rockaway Park filmed an orange-yellow light object hovering above the ocean on November 6, 2020 at 8:40 p.m. Initially, the object appeared circular and spherical, with the top taken off, as if a bite of a cookie
as if
was taken out. The object
the
was
UAP,
visible and
UAP
glowing
was
for
a,
approximately
was a convertible.
30 to 40 seconds before the witness
and the aliens were just chilling
within
out,
within less than 20
flying
seconds,
the
illumined object seemed to materialize completely. Here's the video we have on this.
I'll see it. Wow. There it is. It's UFO. UAP. Hell no. Hell no. That's not a UAP. It's clearly something where the... You can see it's there's a lens flare. Now I'm the meta bunker. See? It's just a point of light.
Giz 112169. A Texas witness at Houston on November 11th, 2020 at 2:58 p.m. filmed an oval-shaped shining silver object in the sky for over an hour.
Whoa.
It made no sound. Later, while the video was being observed, a second object was noticed that was not visible to the naked eye. The object or craft made no noise. Here's the footage we have on this.
Let's see it. That there's a UAP. UAPP.
Whoa.
The bleep. What in the hell? Man, these UAPs are just crazy.
Josh Allen, 415 yards.
Whoa. Football's going on. He doesn't even care about
163.
He didn't even care about the UAP. He's just watching football.
On November 7, 2020, at 11:30 p.m., filmed six giant lights hovering in the sky. The only comment from the witness was, "I kept the camera very steady on the object." Take a look at the video we have on this.
Let's check it out. Holy moly. Now that's interesting. That's definitely a UAP. Don't know what that is. That's a classic UAP. Pretty cool.
Pretty cool!
Thank you for watching the cool stream of Beowulf. This was the cool stream. Thank you.
Thank you.